Hello students, so in the previous class in the chapter that is Why Do We Fall Ill, we have discussed about that what are the principle of the prevention. Okay, and in the principle of the prevention student, we have discussed that how can we prevent ourselves by taking a proper, by following the proper measure to proper measures and which prevent the attack of the infectious agent to us, and ultimately it will prevent us from the diseases to occur. Okay, so we can say that we should follow the proper principle of prevention, the preventive measure to protect, in order to protect ourselves. Let me remind you some of the preventive measure, students. So we had discussed that we should live in a such a kind of a living condition that should be proper, as well as that should not be overcrowded, because you know that if it will be overcrowded, ultimately the chances of the spread of the disease will be very high. Okay, so we can say that we should prefer in such kind of a living condition which should be a proper one. Okay, proper living condition. Second one, student, we should take water that should not be contaminated. Okay, because if you take contaminated food and water, ultimately this food, this contaminated water will lead to the chances of the disease to us, like cholera you have heard, diarrhea you have heard. So we can say avoid to take contaminated water. Then the next one is, student, that is, next one is never buy food articles which is sold at roadside, or which is, okay, never buy the food article which is sold at the roadside or which is open. Okay, because what will happen, the microbes will be present in it. You know that the flies, they can take the microbes from the infected place to the food article. So we can take that microbe and ultimately leads to the diseases to occur. Okay, cover the entire drainage system. The entire drainage system should be covered properly. Okay, because if it will be open, since it consisting of the waste material, so it will lead to the disease. Now, not only the drainage system, student, but we should cover the stored water, the stagnant water, because you know that the stagnant water is responsible for the breeding of the mosquitoes. Okay, that will be a good place for the breeding of the mosquitoes. Okay, so we can see that avoid storage of water. Then be hygienic. Not only you, but you should encourage the other people also to be hygienic, because the more hygienic you will be, the more hygienic the condition will be there, student. So the more hygienic you will be there, and more hygienic the people around you will be there, ultimately it will lead to the less production of the diseases in that particular area. Okay, as well as finally, student, we should aware the people about the immunization or vaccination. Okay, so we should aware people regarding immunization or vaccination. So these are some of the preventive measures, students, that a person should take to avoid the attack of the microbes, to avoid the chances of the infection to that person. Okay, so this is all about the principle of prevention. Now, only we are also discussing about that how not only this, but we can control the prevention of the transmission of the diseases. And for that, there is a rule, you can say that if we will want to prevent the transmission, we should follow the 5 F's. Okay, what is that? 5 F's. The first one is the students, that is fingers. First one is the finger,
flute.
So you see, healthy person. So you see, student, if suppose you will take the fluid, or if you take the water which is safe, which is not contaminated, safe for a drinking purpose, ultimately that will make us a healthy person, that will not going to cause any kind of disease to us. Okay, so we should protect the water, we should take the pure water or the safe water, we should avoid the contaminated water, not only this. But we should cover the stored water, because you know that the stored water is a very proper place for the breeding of the mosquito, which causes a lot of diseases. Okay, so we can say that flutes, if we take the proper care of the flute by taking the good amount of water and pure water or safe water, then as well as if we will cover the stored water, or we should not store the water. Okay, as well as okay, if we drink pure water, if we avoid stored water, ultimately this will make a person a healthier person, because it will lead a person to a disease free person. Okay, so it will help in reducing the disease, student. Ultimately physically that person will be a healthy person. Next one. Finger. So you see, student, how finger. So we used to go to the washroom, or we used to touch the things around us. Then without washing your hand, if you will eat it or if you will drink water with that, ultimately the microbes which is present on our fingers, it will goes inside the living organism. Okay, and there they will multiply, and because of the multiplication, more and more microbes will be formed inside the body, ultimately causes a disease to the person. Okay, so we can say that the fingers or your hand should be properly washed, which will help in reducing the effect of the disease to a person. Okay, so we can say that wash hand before taking food. Wash hand before taking food. Second one, wash hand after defecation. Okay, so wash hand before taking food, wash hand after defecation. Okay, so this will help in the removal of the this will help in the removal of the disease and make a person a healthy person. So second one, we should take care of the fingers also. We should take care of our hand, you can say. So we should take care of our fingers. Next one is a student, that is flies. Flies. How flies, students? So you know that the flies, they act as a vector. They used to carry the microbes from the infected person or from the waste or the infected object to that of the healthy or to the other object. When I was discussing about the prevention, at that time also I said that you have seen, student, the food articles. The food articles, they are open. If they are open, the flies, they used to sit on the excreta of the living organism. That excreta, that is the fecal matter, that excreta will consisting of a, that excreta consisting of a microbes, okay, the infectious agent on it. Now these infectious agent, it will get stick to the body of the flies, right? As it will get stick to the body of the flies, now again the fly moves and reaches to the food article of a of food article. Now the microbe from the body, it will reaches to the food article. Now when you take that food article, the food enter in your body along with the microbes, ultimately causes a problem, causes a disease to the person. So we can say that flies, it act as a transmission, it help in the transmission of the microbe from infected place to a healthy place and to the healthy person. Okay, and make a healthy person as an infected person. So we should take care of this. We should control flies. The first thing, control flies. Now the question is that how can we control the flies, students? So you see, students, if proper hygiene will be there, hygienic condition will be there. You have seen that flies basically occur where in the unhygienic conditions. Okay, so if hygienic or if proper hygienic environment or condition will be there, then the chances of the flies to come and sit will be get reduced. Okay, will be controlled. So we can say that we should control the flies by taking proper hygiene. As well as we should cover the food. I told you that flies, they used to take the microbe from an infected area, from an unhygienic place to the hygienic place, to the food article which will be consumed later on by the living organism. So we can say that we should cover the food. Okay. So what we can do, students, we should not only control the flies, but we should cover the food also. Okay, so control flies as well as cover the food. So this is what, this is the third S, student, that is flies. Okay, control flies and cover food. Now we will move to the next two. Okay, I'm rubbing it again and then we can understand all of them collectively. Okay. Then the next two, students, which is left, you see, that is, next one is the field. Fields, students. When we talk about the field, student, how the field F is responsible for causing this problem. So you have seen, healthy person. You see, students, that the crops that we take it from that of the field only, right? Now these consisting of the soil, it consisting of a dust, it consisting of a dirt, and if we will take it raw as it is, then ultimately it will causes a problem, because that soil also consisting of a microbes in it. right? So when you take that kind of a crop or that kind of a fruit or vegetables which consisting of microbes in it, so ultimately it will lead to the problem, ultimately it will lead to the disease. Okay, so what we can do for that, students, we should take the vegetables, we should take the fruits from the field, but before eating it we should properly wash it. Okay, when we wash it, then the microbes which is present over the surface of the vegetable and the fruit, it will be get removed. Okay, so we can say that the vegetable or the fruits that we used to take from the field, before eating it, what we can do, we should wash the vegetable. Okay, when we wash the vegetable, student, the effect of the microbes that will be get reduced, because the microbes, you can say, it will be washed away from the water. Okay, so if we wash it properly and then we will take it, then ultimately it will not cause any kind of a disease to us. Okay, now is that only the fact? No, you have heard about the people, they used to use the field for excreting or for excretion. So we should avoid this, because you know that the excretion of the living organism, excretion of the human being, also consisting of our microbes. So that you can say that will be a place for the microbes to attack on it. So you can say that ultimately these microbes will come in the atmosphere, in the air, and we should avoid it so that we will be healthy. Okay, so we can say that avoid open defecation. Okay, avoid open defecation. Finally, student, flood. So you see, student, proper drainage system should be there. You see that because of the flood, the drains, it be fulfilled, it will be filled with the water, and ultimately the water start coming outside, right? And these water will get spilled all over the road, and you can understand that since the drainage system is there, or student, or the drain consisting of the waste water, consisting of a lot of microbes. So because of the flood, water starts coming out from the drains, and it will get spread over the road. And since this drain consisting of the microbes, so ultimately it will cause a problem. Ultimately it will be cause the disease to a healthy person. Okay, so proper drainage system should be there. Okay, so we can say the flood causes the, it disrupt the drainage system. So the flood is the cause of that. If we will control it, the proper drainage system should be there, so it will be there. You have heard about it, student, that sometimes what happened in the drains, if the plastic and the other, so students, you have heard about that many time it happens that the plastic objects are there, it get choked into the pipe of the drainage system. And if it get choked in the pipe of a drainage system, ultimately you can understand that it will not make the water to flow or to go through the pipes, through that of the drain, it not allow the water to get drained easily. Okay, so for that purpose, a proper drainage system should be there. Because of that, what will happen? We will say that what will happen if the proper drainage system will be not there, then water will start coming out. Okay, and if the water will start coming out with the water with the out from that of the sewer pipe or the drain, so you can see that since it consists of a lot of waste material, so that will get spread over the roads, spread over the area, and ultimately it will make the condition unhygienic, and the possibility of the diseases will become higher. Okay. Okay, so possibility of the diseases will be very high, yes, students. Now, not only this, students. Okay, we are seeing that a flood is there, as well as the water which is coming to our houses, it should be treated well. Not only this, students. If you talk about the flood, if you are talking about the drainage system, the water which should be thrown or which should be mixed with that of the river, it should be properly treated. Then we will release it to the river, because what will happen if we will not treat it properly, then the chemicals which is present in it, it will also going to mix with the river water, and ultimately it will degrade the quality of the water, as well as it causes the water pollution. Okay, so we can say that what we can do, the first thing, that a proper drainage system should be there. Proper drainage system should be there. Then the next one is treatment of the water. Treatment of water. So you see, student, if we will consider all these things, then ultimately we will become a healthy person. Okay, so we should take care of all these 5 S. Let me remind the all the 5 S again. What are that? That is fluids, fingers. Fluids are there, finger. Fluid is there, student. Finger is there. Then next one is the flies. Okay, so we can say flies are there. Then that of the feet, and finally flood. So you see, student, if suppose we will take care of all the 5 S, include the fluid, include the finger, include the flies, include the field, and that of the flood, ultimately the chances of the diseases will be reduced, and we can say we are able to prevent the transmission of the diseases from an infected area, from an infected person, to that of a healthy area or healthy person. Okay, so we should take care of these 5 F's to prevent the transmission of diseases. Okay, so this is all about the prevention of the diseases. Now, when we were talking about the preventive measures, students, we discussed a very important thing, and that is we should aware the people about immunization, or we should aware the people about vaccination. Right, the proper, if your immune system is a strong, student, ultimately the chances of the disease to occur to a person will also get reduced. Okay, so this will be, your immune system will be strengthened by the immunization process. Okay, so let us discuss about the immunization, which is a very important topic. Immunization. Okay. Basically, what happens when a person get infected, when you or me get infected, then what will happen? The microbes enter into our body, right? When the microbes enter in our body, our immune system start preparing itself to fight with that infection, or to control the effect of that infection to our diseases. From that of the diseases, right? So our immune system, it makes it ready to fight with the infection that causes disease. But in this process, the immune system take time, right? And till that it take time, that infection already had attack, already causes the disease to us, and we feel fever or we get infected because of the infectious agent, right? Now, then the immune system fight with it, and ultimately then we become healthy afterward. But you see, it is a property of our immune system that it used to recognize the type of a microbe. Okay, so it is able to recognize the microbe which already had attacked. So this time what happened, when the next time the same microbe entered in our body, this time the immune system is already ready to fight, and it will take no time to protect ourselves from that particular microbe or infectious agent. So what is this? This is the process of the immunization. So keeping this concept in our mind, Edward Jenner, he was the first English physician was there. He first of all, he talked about that of the immunization. Basically what happened, at that time, in his country, more than 10% of the people, they died because of the smallpox virus, because of the smallpox disease, okay, which get infected by the viruses. So you see that at that time there was no such kind of a vaccine for the smallpox. So Edward Jenner, he was continuously observing the people who were suffering from the smallpox. He find one thing, that the milkmaid, the milkman who is very close to a cow, and the cow also suffers from a pox, that is known as a cow pox. So if cow is suffering from a cow pox, the milkman who is very close to that cow which is having the cow pox does not get the pox. Okay, so you know that a pox is a highly infectious disease. Okay, so we can say that if the cow is having the cow pox, the pox should get transferred to the milkman also. It means the milkman should also suffer from it, but it does not happen. So he thought that maybe it is because the blisters of the pox may get reaches to the body of the milkman. Okay, and at first, because of that, the smallpox is not affecting the milkman. Let me tell you again, student. You see, at that time the people, they were suffering from the smallpox, but the milkman, they do not suffer from it. Especially the milkman where the cow, they are having the pox. It means cow pox. Okay. So he finds that the blisters of the pox, the pox may enter into the body of the milkman, and it makes the immune system to recognize the kind of a microbe which causes the pox, and because of that the milkman do not suffer from the smallpox. Okay, so keeping this in this concept in mind, he said about the vaccine. Actually, when we say the vaccine, student, the term cow means vaca. Okay, and since he got this idea of the vaccination from the cowpox itself, that is why he used a term for it, that is vaccination. So he said that if our immune system recognizes the kind of a microbe attacking on it, or already or its relative, the kind of a microbe or relative, so the immune system make itself this much strong that it can fight it if the microbe will attack again to the body. Okay, so that is what, that is immunization, that is the vaccination. In the process of the vaccination, with the help of the injection, they used to inject the dead microbes, which is very similar with that of the living microbes. So they used to inject the dead microbes. Now the immune system, they recognize these dead microbes, and when in the future, when the living microbes attack this living microbes, or the family of this living microbes attack on the body, the immune system is this much able to fight with that microbes. Okay, so this is what, this is the immunization. Okay.